Very strong weather pattern is coming to the U.S. starting tomorrow night, everyone. This is bringing chances not only for tornadoes, but potentially strong tornadoes, even long-lived tornadoes. Bring chances for hail, very large hail, damaging winds on the second storm. Still bringing a lot of ice, chances for ice storm, a lot of freezing rain building up, a lot of snow as well. Just all in general, a very strong scenario coming around. Now, this is going to strengthen even stronger as we go into Wednesday and Thursday on the second storm, showing it's getting worse, everybody. So for today, you can see it has upgraded again. So now we have a slight risk, and this is for tornadoes. And you can see this, it is chances for tornadoes. It has bumped up to a 5%. And these are right where we have these strong cells that I showed you earlier as they pass through around 6 and 7 p.m. for tonight, all the way from southeastern Texas going into southwestern Louisiana and going a little bit northern as you go by later for this evening. Then it's going to be offshore while you go overnight, still bringing some strong storms potentially over here by the West Bank as you go by into tomorrow morning. Then it's going to be for tomorrow where you just have a lot of thunderstorm activity coming through, but still showing you have a chance for tornadoes in the north. And you still have the marginal, but I'm still showing you have a lot of strong cells that passes by as you go from 8 to 10 o'clock at night. A lot of good hail cores come with them, and still showing a chance for a quick spin up with Colorado State University, and still stretching all the way into northern Michigan, and it's still going towards the northeast. This is bringing you some thunderstorms for tomorrow as well, some freezing rain. You get some snow as well. It is going to start adding up for New England, but the severe aspect of it is going to start ramping up, everybody. And once again, it starts with tomorrow night, and it has grown in its area, and it really starts for tomorrow night. So you get these storms passing by from the south, but as this comes right off the Rockies, you still get that low pressure, you still get some very strong cells, still showing some strong cells passing through Nebraska as well. Look at the hail core coming through with that. Very strong cells, so just be aware of that as you go by for 7 o'clock for tomorrow. But this is where storms pull all the way to the north, all the way from the south, just thunderstorms coming through. You might have an occasional lightning strike coming out of these storms. What builds over here in the Central Plains starts getting really active and growing really fast. And this is where it could tap into that energy and really get strong. This is where your significant tornado perimeters just go off the wall. You get a lot of strong hail cores coming through there. Look like maybe a QLCS tornado would be possible. I don't see a lot of discrete cells, but it shows it stays strong all the way through, all the way to early AM as that goes by into Missouri with a line of storms. Now, this is going to bring some chances for damaging winds with those storms as well. But this is where everything really starts kicking in as you go into Sunday. Now, we can only see till noontime, but you can already start to see that this is where we have 60 dew points in the north, 70 along the Gulf. We have a lot of instability, and this is where you get a lot of strong winds aloft, is right where you have all these cells right here popping up for central and southern Illinois, going through north, northwestern Indiana. This is where you have chances for some tornadoes to pop up, everybody. Get strong storms all the way into Michigan, but it's starting to show some very strong cells popping up just in the beginning of this scenario. And this is where it's going to continue for quite some time. And once we get started on this, it's going to train all week with storms, possibly lasting all the way until Friday. And you can see the storms that's coming up from the south, coming up from Mississippi into Alabama. Very strong cells coming right there with a lot of good hail cores and those as well. So be aware, it is going to be a very strong Sunday. Now, as this moves through for Sunday all the way to the East Coast, this is where it's going to change. And these storms are going to tap into the east side of the U.S. as we go through Monday. And then we're going to start getting some more storms coming through as well. And we still have that one for Wednesday on the next storm system. So I'm going to show you some information real quick, what's going on with the storm system. Also, what's coming behind it, because that second storm still showing it's going to be stronger than the first storm, everybody. And not only the quick flare up on your significant tornado perimeter, still for possibility for a quick spin up going through Wisconsin, a little bit from Michigan. Michigan has dwindled down. You can see how it really picks up as you go through Saturday evening with significant tornado perimeters. So all these cells that start sparking up for Nebraska going through Kansas, this is where it's really tapping into the instability, and this is where you have a lot of chances for a strong tornado all the way south through Texas. But you can see it really don't go that far south. It stays right around Nebraska, Kansas, then it moves into Missouri as you go by into the morning. But you can see it starts weakening down as it goes through Missouri. still comes through. You still have a chance for tornadoes, but it starts weakening down. But look how it comes right back as you go by 1 o'clock in the evening, as you start getting those cells I showed you in the beginning of the video, starts becoming our chances for tornadoes. This is going to grow as we get our daytime heating. This is right at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Now, when you look at your vorticity, you can see how this strengthens up all the way for Sunday, goes towards the East Coast for Monday. Then we get that next storm system. Looks like it's going to last all the way from Wednesday into Friday. So once we start getting some storms building as we go through Wednesday, this is going to be northern for Wednesday. Very strong winds coming through. But look how it builds again for Thursday coming through. Then it comes through again all Thursday evening into Friday, bringing even more storms. And look how you have the high pressure revolving around, bringing everything around while you're getting that trough coming together all in one piece. It could last even longer. It could go all the way towards Saturday. Still showing once you go through Saturday evening, you will get those stronger winds aloft that will help you get those cells going, get them stronger. Also, what builds as you go through Sunday for Ohio Valley, you do have stronger winds aloft where it helps keep the thunderstorms going all the way until Monday and Monday afternoon, all the way along the East Coast. So the thunderstorms will keep ramping up. But look at the next storm system showing even more strength. So as you go in for Tuesday, coming in for Tuesday night right across the South Central, growing as you go overnight to the early morning hours, these winds will help spark up some strong supercells. And as you go through the afternoon, it sparks up again right across Ohio Valley, carrying into the interior northeast. Then the winds stay there for a couple of days while we're still getting the other storms. We're going into a very strong scenario, everyone. Your instability will be there later on this evening as those storms come across from Wisconsin, some of Michigan, but mostly showing for Wisconsin. Then we go into tomorrow night, really ramps up the instability on those thunderstorms that grow all the way towards Ohio Valley with Indiana and Michigan. You can see this as well going into Sunday afternoon. So you do have instability for those storms, plus all the instability that is going to tap into all day long for the mid-Mississippi and lower Mississippi Valley. Then when you go overnight and for Monday, it grows right back from the interior northeast all into the south, all the way to New England, all the way down the East Coast. Very strong storms coming through. Then as we go into next Tuesday and Wednesday, a big group of instability coming all the way north. This is going all the way into Wisconsin, maybe even some of the UP of Michigan getting some lift, everybody. A lot of strong food for these storms to grow on. And look how it goes all the way to Wednesday afternoon, comes across for Thursday, right across towards Mid-Atlantic from the south. A lot of strong lift in the south. There's going to be chances for strong tornadoes and very large hail. Then you go for Thursday afternoon. It's still giving you all this instability all the way until Friday. It could last for multiple days. I think we'll see updates from National Weather Service, long ranges as we go from Wednesday, Thursday, and possibly Friday. Showing what your lightning strikes, you can see this with the Ural. You do get some strong storms that come through later this evening, even chances for large hail. All that purple to that white is a lot of lightning strikes, a very strong updraft, bring your chances for large hail. While you get the storms in the south, that will transfer over towards Mississippi as you go by for Saturday afternoon. But look how you go through Saturday night. It busts right through that cap. You get chances for large hail in the pink and white while these storms go all the way through Iowa. Then once you go through the afternoon, this is where it grows for Sunday, all the way for Illinois, Indiana, and Michigan. And look over here along the south. This is where you have a lot of instability, a lot of thunderstorms coming through, even get to the 70 dew points along the Gulf. Very large hail, and this is where you get the strong tornadoes that can pop up as you go through Sunday evening, everybody. All the way until Sunday night for the mid-Mississippi Valley. Then it goes through the lower Mississippi Valley as you go all the way into the early a.m., still bringing that purple and white, still bringing maybe a squall line down, maybe a QLCS tornado can come out of that, going all the way into New Orleans by Monday morning. Then it expands all the way out towards the northeast in the mid-Atlantic as you go through Monday evening. And look what comes around for Tuesday into Wednesday. Tuesday night, bringing very large hail all the way down from Texas towards Iowa. Look at this, all the way into Indiana, Ohio. Just a lot of strong storms, bringing a lot of updraft. This is large hail and be chances for strong tornadoes. Look at this, getting getting even stronger as you go by Wednesday evening, all the way from Texas, Arkansas, southern Illinois, going through Indiana. And it does go through northern Mississippi, northern Louisiana, a little bit of western Tennessee, western Kentucky. But it stays in this region for quite some time as we go through for Wednesday evening. So watch this. So as we start right into the Wednesday afternoon, you're getting these strong storms going for hours, large hail, chances for strong tornadoes again, I do believe. And look how you go all the way to Wednesday night into Thursday morning, and it's still another day. So they had it all the way in this area. I'm seeing a lot of chances for flooding as well. As you go by for Thursday morning and Thursday afternoon, then it starts building a little bit lower over here for the western side of the Mid-Mississippi Valley, and that goes further towards the south as well. Just some very strong storms coming through and lasting for a few days. And I'm seeing a big area where it's going to drain in precipitation, where you're going to have some flooding. I will be quick. You can see with the dew points, it raises all the way up as we go through Saturday night and overnight. This is where you get into 60 dew points. You get in 70s right along the Gulf. And very strong dew points helping these thunderstorms grow as you go all night long for Sunday. Go all the way from Monday all the way towards the coast. Then here you come with that next storm system going all the way up for Tuesday and Wednesday. Once again, bringing these strong dew points, bring the 60s, bring the 70s along the Gulf. And this is going to bring the same scenario. A very strong atmosphere, a lot of instability, a lot of dew points for your thunderstorms. And it's just going to keep growing all the way from Wednesday into Friday. Maybe even get some of Saturday in on it. Showing as we go Saturday night into Sunday morning, this is where those group of storms really grow up. And this is where you have a lot of chances for large hail. Also with the banding, this is where you get a lot of strong updrafts. You can also get a chance for a strong tornado as you go through Sunday. Strong storms bringing strong tornadoes possibility, everybody. As you go all the way into Monday, now it goes all the way across the Mid-Mississippi Valley, all the way to the lower Mississippi Valley. This is where you have the big hail, strong tornado possibilities as well. And it grows all the way towards the East Coast as you go into Monday. Then we have that next storm system coming through. Next storm system looking just as strong, everybody. As you go all the way for late Tuesday night into Wednesday morning, this is where the storm starts sparking up and you get a strong low pressure all the way down to a 987, 989. While you get a lot of storms going all the way from Wisconsin all the way towards Texas. This is bringing you large hail. This is going to bring you chances for strong tornadoes as well, because you do have the strong winds aloft kicking in on these cells as it comes all the way across. And look what builds over here for Ohio, while you have another set growing over here for Wednesday morning. And look at what happens when you get the daytime heating in the afternoon as you go through Wednesday. It grows stronger in the same areas. You just train in for hours. You get a lot of banding, a lot of thick thunderstorms, bringing strong tornadoes, bring a lot of large hail and some damaging winds. Look how it just lasts for hours in that one region of just storms going round after round. So a lot of people is going to get storms coming by, but some people all the way from the lower Ohio Valley to the Mid-Mississippi Valley, you're going to get storms passing by potentially for about a 24-hour period, maybe even longer, because now we're going all the way into Friday and we still have the storms coming. Still showing is bringing that 40 to 50 miles per hour wind gusts, even some pockets of 60. You can see with GFS as well, still showing the same scenario. It has weakened down a little bit on your damaging winds that's come across for Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, southern Michigan, and northern Kentucky. It did take away those 60s I was in there earlier. Now it's showing 50s, which is still bad enough, but thank God something calmed down. Starting to get a better picture of the snowfall as well, besides what comes across the West Coast, all across the Rockies, what comes across the upper Midwest, showing by the Euro and by the GFS that it's starting to get an agreement of very heavy snowfall, but where it's coming down and not all over all of Wisconsin. It's going to be northern Wisconsin, a good bit of Minnesota, and the Dakotas, and of course the UP. Still showing a lot of freezing rain coming through, even the chances for the ice storm for northern Michigan, the UP of Michigan, and northern Wisconsin. You can see that with GFS as well, and what goes into Canada. Also possibility for New England, for upstate New York, Vermont, and New Hampshire. But bringing all in all, a lot of heavy rainfall all along the West Coast, all the way for the upper Midwest, all across Ohio and mid-Mississippi, lower Mississippi valleys. Matter of fact, this has grown since this morning, showing a lot of heavy rainfall. Getting a big pocket, anywhere from 2 to 4 inches, all the way from eastern Texas, going all the way towards Indiana and Ohio. A very heavy swath of very heavy rainfall. This is where the storms are banding for hours. But I will keep you updated. I will give you another update for tomorrow. I know it's Sabbath, but there's going to be a lot of lives at risk, everybody, as soon as we go into tomorrow night, and especially as we go into Sunday. So I will see you again for tomorrow morning for a quick update. It won't be one for tomorrow afternoon, but we'll see you early Sunday once again. Thank you again for your time, everybody. Please prepare for these storms any way you can. If you are in Western Tennessee, Western Kentucky, Central and Southern Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, some of Southern Michigan, and as you go through Eastern Nebraska, Eastern Kansas through Missouri, a big hot spot for some very strong storms. Please be aware of this. Now, before I go for the evening, Psalm 123. Unto thee lift I up mine eyes, O thou that dwellest in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of servants look unto the hand of their masters, and as the eyes of a maiden unto the hand of her mistress, so our eyes wait upon the Lord our God, until that he have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, O Lord, have mercy upon us, for we are exceedingly filled with contempt. Our soul is exceedingly filled with the scorning of those that are at ease, and with the contempt of the proud. Amen. Have a great evening, everyone. Thank you for all the shares and the likes and getting the words out to other people. I really appreciate that. Please make sure you check on your neighbors. I'll see you first thing in the morning. And remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. You should hear that echo around my house. Amen. Have a great night, everybody.